next slide, which might make more sense. सबसे टॉप लेफ्ट वाला फिगर देखना, करण एरो और समथिंग, यस। अभी आप यहां पे देख सकते हो दो सिग्नल्स का फेस ट्रेस है, जो ग्रीन है और ब्लू है। अगर आप 100 से 200 हर्ट्ज का जोन देखोगे तो वहां पे दोनों का फेज मैच हो रहा है, दोनों का फेज रीडिंग सेम है, मतलब दोनों फेज में आ रहे हैं, तो हम इसको बोलेंगे दैट दिस सिग्नल इज इन फेज। अभी एक आप देख सकते हो ये नीचे जा रहा है, तो ये क्या बोलते हैं, ये लैगिंग है, लेकिन लैगिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू व्हाट, वो हम बाद में देखेंगे। दूसरी चीज हमें देखनी है कि दोनों का स्लोप देखना, दोनों जो है साथ में, उससे पहले भी साथ में, बाद में भी साथ में, मतलब ये दोनों टाइम में है, इसमें से कोई भी ऐसा नहीं है कि कोई ज्यादा लेट है या कम लेट है, दोनों इक्वली लेट आ रहे हैं, तो दोनों टाइम में है और दोनों फेज में भी है। तो जब भी दो सिग्नल्स फेज में होते हैं क्या होता है, प्लस 6 dB। तो अगर ये दो सिग्नल्स हम ऐड करेंगे तो जो रिजल्टेंट मिलेगा हमें 100 टू 200 के बीच में प्लस 6 dB अपने को गेन मिलेगा। अब हम आते हैं बॉटम लेफ्ट पे, यहां पे आप देख सकते हो कि जो ब्लू है वो इतना ज्यादा स्टीप नहीं है, बट जो ग्रीन है वो बहुत ज्यादा स्टीप है। सो इन दिस द सेकेंड फिगर यू कैन सी दैट द ब्लू ट्रेस इज नॉट दैट स्टीप, वेयर एज द ग्रीन इज वेरी स्टीपर। सो जो हमने देखा था क्या है, स्टीपनेस जो हमने देखा था, जितना ज्यादा स्टीप उतना ज्यादा टाइम डिफरेंस। तो इस पिक्चर में दोनों के स्टीपनेस में डिफरेंस है, दैट मींस दोनों टाइम में नहीं है, एक लेट आ रहा है और जो ग्रीन वाला है वो उससे भी ज्यादा लेट आ रहा है, ठीक है। बट जो पॉइंट है जो अभी करण ने जो क्रॉस किया है वो उस पॉइंट में, सिर्फ उस पॉइंट पे इन लोग इन फेज है। सो इस पर्टिकुलर सिग्नल को हम बोलेंगे कि ये दो सिग्नल्स अराउंड 160 हर्ट्ज पे इन फेज है, लेकिन ये लोग हमें आउट ऑफ टाइम है। सो इन दिस पिक्चर वी विल सी दैट, वी सी दैट द ब्लू इज नॉट दैट स्टीप, वेयर एज द ग्रीन इज वेरी स्टीपर, एंड स्टीप इज समथिंग दैट सजेस्ट्स मोर डिले। सो द ग्रीन सिग्नल इज मच मोर, इज कमिंग मच मोर, इज मच लेटर देन द ब्लू सिग्नल, एंड हेंस इट इज आउट ऑफ टाइम। However, there is one point where both the phase traces intersect. That is the point where the phase reading for both the signals is the same. That is the point where they are in phase. So, the difference between the top and the bottom plot is that in the top plot, both the signals are in phase and in time from 100 to 200 hertz because they are completely same. And in the bottom, both the signals are just in phase at one particular point, but they are out of time at all the other points. Okay. Bottom right. So when you move on to the bottom right, you can see that the slopes are completely different. Completely different, plus from 100 to 200 hertz, they are not intersecting anywhere. So they do not have the same phase at any point. So they are out of phase, and because their slopes are different, they are out of time. Bottom right का अगर आप picture देखोगे तो उसमें आप देख सकते हो कि दोनों phase traces का slope कुछ अलग ही है, वो कहीं पे भी एक दूसरे के साथ intersect नहीं कर रहे हैं। इसका मतलब उनका कहीं पे भी सेम फेस ट्रेस नहीं है 100 से 200 हर्ट्ज के बीच में, जिसका मतलब यह है कि वो लोग आउट ऑफ फेज है, और साथ में क्योंकि उनका स्लोप अलग है वो लोग आउट ऑफ टाइम भी है। तो ये सिग्नल्स अगर अभी आप देखोगे, लेफ्ट टॉप सिग्नल्स स्लोप्स मैचिंग, फेज मैचिंग, ये सिग्नल होगा इन टाइम इन फेज। लेफ्ट बॉटम स्लोप्स नॉट मैचिंग, phase intersecting, in phase, out of time. Right bottom, slopes not matching, phase not matching, it is out of time, out of phase. That's it. that's where I'll stop with phase, I think. New share, okay. तो ये चीजें याद रखो बस. इसका स्क्रीनशॉट कैन यू सी द हाँ
yes.
इसका स्क्रीनशॉट लेना है, स्क्रीनशॉट ले लो, फोटो लेना है फोटो ले लो. सिर्फ ये चीजें आपको याद रखनी है. फेज में डाउनवर्ड स्लोप मतलब मेजरमेंट सिग्नल लेट है, अपवर्ड स्लोप मतलब जल्दी है, कुछ फ्लैट है मतलब टाइम है, से इन टाइम है. अगर ये स्लोप जो है बढ़ते जा रहा है मतलब टाइम इंक्रीज हो रहा है. उसके बाद अगर सेम स्लोप है और ओवरलैपिंग है इन टाइम इन फेज, सेम स्लोप और ओवरलैप नहीं कर रहे इन टाइम आउट ऑफ फेज, सेम अलग स्लोप है लेकिन कहीं एक जगह पे क्रॉस कर रहे इन फेज आउट ऑफ टाइम, और अगर भलता ही सबका फेज है और स्लोप है तो आउट ऑफ फेज आउट ऑफ टाइम. और इसका रेफरेंस तो आपको पता चल गया कि अगर इन टाइम इन फेज है तो 6 dB मिलेगा जब फेज रहेगा, जब कंप्लीटली आउट ऑफ फेज है तो हमें कैंसिलेशन मिलेगा. I think with smart, I'll stop here and let you take on the live measurement. I think the live measurements will make much more sense right now.
Okay. एक चीज़
मेरे को और जो आपको बोलनी थी, I think मैं वो slide आपको बाद में दिखाता हूँ. I don't know if you can see something or not. Yeah, you. I think.
No, we can see your. DAW.
Yeah, the DAW thing. ठीक है. So, और दो तीन स्लाइड्स है स्मार्ट के बारे में जो आपको मैं थोड़े टाइम बाद बताऊंगा. अब थोड़े मेजरमेंट्स होंगे तो शायद थोड़ा सा सेंस बनना चालू बनेगा. तो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू मेजरमेंट करंट.
ओके, सो आई एम जस्ट गोना शेयर माय डेस्कटॉप. होल्ड ऑन. ओके, इज माय डेस्कटॉप विजिबल?
यस
यस.
We were here. We'll just quickly go through what is the remaining part. Rajesh has done a phenomenal job for explaining smart in full detail. And any of you guys have a question, you can koi bhi question hai smart regarding smart or anything, you can send it to us. Rajesh can address it. Just to talk about curves that you're expecting. There is a white paper by most companies that sub major companies jo dekhenge, they're not really using a live flat response per se. This is a response in a white paper of L-Acoustics, and then you can see the response that they're creating out of. So you can see that they have created. Why is it not going ahead? Yeah. This is the white paper of L-Acoustics where they've given the response of 12 VDOSC with at 40 meters, jo unka by default preset hai, and same with Kiva and a single process, a single flow monitor where they've shown the response that they're coming out of the camp. So aap dekhenge ki unka bade se bade company bhi jyada unka flat response nahi hai. बहुत से लोग LS सेक्शन में एम्फेसाइज करते हैं, एंड जो लास्ट वीक हमारे सेशन ऑन सबवूफर्स आया, वी डिड वेटिंग कर्व्स ए वाई एंड सी, वेयर यू कुड हैव सीन दैट दे आर बेस्ड ऑन द इनवर्स ऑफ द इक्वल वर्ल्ड लाउडनेस कॉन्टूर्स, एंड इट शोज लोअर सेंसिटिविटी एट लो फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज, एंड प्रॉब्ली वन ऑफ द रीजन वाई दे गिव दिस लिटिल मोर बेस एनहांसमेंट फॉर दिस सोनिक अपील at low frequency. So I'm going to be targeting, jo hamara target rahega will be a little enhancement in LF, where we are trying to kind of roll off at maybe 3 dB an octave from about 100 hertz to 1 kilohertz. And if you go ahead, you again see even on the DNB white paper or Adamson's white paper, those who've been attending the webinars on Adamson, you can see their response curves are all similar. So this is their J series, the J8, J12, jo bade liner hai, ya Y8, Y12, the V8, V12. They pretty much have a very similar response where they've given this enhancement at low frequencies on their measurement curves. So it's there in the white paper, it's there in the net, you can read all about it. And then when we
just a second, because you have already shown the this thing, the tonal balance. There's one slide I'll just show off immediately so that we don't have to get back there.
Okay, sure. So you're sharing a screen?
Yeah, I'm sharing a screen.
Okay, sure. Go ahead.
So
for a couple of minutes, I'll just be back.
Yeah. Okay. So जो अभी करण ने बोला कि हर एक सिस्टम का एक अलग अलग ये है टोनल बनाया हुआ है, तो सेम चीज आपको स्मार्ट से वो और एक फायदा होता है कि आप जो सेम कैरेक्टर है वो हर इसमें ला सकते हो, और तभी है ये जो टारगेट कर्व्स काम में आता है. तो अगर आप स्पीच रिलेटेड कोई प्रोग्राम कर रहे हो, तो आप अगर लेफ्ट टॉप में देख सकते हो कि स्पीच रिलेटेड प्रोग्राम में हमें लो एनर्जी इतनी ज्यादा नहीं होती, तो मोस्टली हम सिस्टम को ट्यून या टोनिंग करते टाइम पे हम इस तरह से टोन करते कि उसका ओवरऑल रिस्पॉन्स थोड़ा सा फ्लैट रहे और 2K के आगे थोड़ा ड्रॉप हो जाए. और अगर हम समझो कोई म्यूजिकल कॉन्सर्ट, मोस्टली हमारे जो पॉप रॉक कॉन्सर्ट्स हो रहे हैं उसमें हमें LF बहुत ज्यादा लगता है कंपेयर टू अपना जो टॉप्स का लेवल है, तो वो आप यहाँ पे राइट हैंड साइड कॉर्नर में देख सकते हो. सिमिलरली अगर रॉक कॉन्सर्ट है तो उसका 300, 400, 500 हर्ट्ज का भी जो जोन है वो भी काफी बड़ा हुआ रहता है. तो आप आपके सिस्टम को बेसिकली इस हिसाब से आप टोन कर सकते हो यूजिंग, आप EQ यूज कर सकते हो, या many a times आप क्रॉसओवर स्लोप, जैसे अभी आपको करण दिखाएगा क्रॉसओवर स्लोप्स और उनका अलाइनमेंट से आप ये डिजायर्ड रिस्पॉन्स जो है वो आप लेके आ सकते हो. सिमिलरली EDM कॉन्सर्ट है, उसमें ज्यादा वोकल होता नहीं है, तो मोस्टली EDM कॉन्सर्ट का अगर मैं कुछ कभी कर रहा हूँ तो मैं 2K टू 4K जो है वो थोड़ा सा निकाल देता हूँ ताकि वो LF जो एनर्जी है वो अच्छे से फील हो. सो बेसिकली ये है. और साथ में ये आप सारे ट्रेसेस जो है, अगर आपको किसी शो किया है और आपको वो पर्टिकुलर गिग का फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स पसंद आया तो आप उसको सेव कर सकते हो और आप आपके अलग अपकमिंग वेन्यूज में आप सेम रिक्रिएट करने का ट्राई कर सकते हो. एवरीवन ओके इंग्लिश. सो पीपल, यू व्हाट यू कैन डू इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन द जॉनर ऑफ म्यूजिक यू कैन एक्चुअली ट्यून एंड टोन द सिस्टम अकॉर्डिंगली एंड हैव अ LF बूस्ट इफ यू आर डूइंग एन EDM कॉन्सर्ट और म्यूजिक कॉन्सर्ट. इफ इट इज मोर ऑफ अ स्पीच बेस्ड यू रियली डोंट नीड द सबवूफर.
Rajesh, I think we lost you.
Yeah, and I can hear him. Okay. Should I just?
Yeah, I think you can just take over. We'll come back to that.
Okay, so I am going to share my desktop. Is it visible now?
No, Rajesh is still showing.
Just hold on. New share, continue, and is it visible now?
No, for some reason it's still stuck on Rajesh's thing.
Probably because I think he'll...
But you're the host, no? I think you... In that option on top, those three dots, is there any option to take over screen?
I guess probably because he has lower internet connection, it's kind of got...
One second, some people are saying that they can see, so I don't know what it is. Maybe I can't see.
Oh, they can?
Yeah. Okay, a lot of people, everyone can see your screen, I think.
Just continuing, like you can see, it's probably the inverse of a C-weighted function. C-weighted is, I think, I can't remember, but it's basically the equal loudness contour of at a loudness level of 100 fons, if I'm not mistaken. But any of the acoustic guys there, you know, I see a lot of you guys there, Kapil and Milin and everyone, these guys, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the C weighted was about, it was 40 for A, 60 for B and 100 for C, if I'm not mistaken. But anyways, when you're adding a crossover, jabhi bhi hum crossover add karte hain, you see in your DSP, you get different slope options. The slopes are also called poles. So basically when you go and they're in different orders. So basically, every order increase is adding a 6 dB attenuation or a roll-off rather than attenuation, is adding a roll-off at the rate of 6 dB an octave. And every So basically, we are dealing with bicord or IR filters, in that every whenever you add a crossover, every time you make it steeper and steeper, you're adding a 90 degree phase shift, which at the crossover frequency would be about half of it. So like you can see this chart, jaise aap chart dekh rahe hain, first order, second order, third order, fourth order, every order would be into a multiplication of 6 dB and octave roll off for a high pass. High pass matlab wo frequency ke upar sare frequency ko pass karne denge, and low pass is wo frequency ke niche sare lower frequency ko pass karne denge. Or a low pass could also be a high cut, matlab high frequency cut kar rahe hain, and low pass could also be a high cut. Okay, so just to give you that they are adding a phase shift. बहुत से लोग उनको लगता है कि getting any speaker can be corrected by adding a DSP, but जैसे ही हम लोग और EQ डालते जाते हैं, we'll get to that. Every time we add an EQ or every time we add a crossover, we are adding phase shift to the signal and discoloring or distorting the signal. तो the way I like to call it is like a tiger chasing its own tail. So it's basically एक शेर अपने पूंछ के पीछे भाग रहा है. So the ultimate solution is not to add a DSP and try to make it a flat curve. Everything adds up into a good system. So it's right from using good components, a good well-designed cabinet, a good well-designed crossover, a good amplifier, a good cable. It's जो आपका audio का signal है, it's the performance of आपके कोई भी audio system is as bad as the weakest part of your audio chain. So if you have a bad cable, if you have a bad XLR, it's got no meaning, because agar aapke paas crore ka system aur ek XLR se aapko hum ya buzz ka noise aa raha hai, so you're just like, it's got no meaning. Aapke crore ekdam kuch fayda hi nahi uska, because aapne ekdam cable, a low quality ka cable use kiya hai. So we'll get to this, and I just want to address, and we're going to measure it by using channel 5. We have about 30 to 45 minutes, so I'll try and show you as much as I can. I originally planned for this to be about almost 1.5 hours. So just looking for crossovers and slopes, we're going to look at three primary crossovers, crossover types. One is the Linkwitz Riley, which we all are familiar with, the Bessel, the Butterworth. ये तीन crossover type हम लोग आज देखने वाले, उनके अलग अलग slope और क्या होता है जब हम लोग उसको use करते हैं. There are plenty of other crossover types. These three are the most common, because they have a minimum ripple in the pass band, मतलब जो हमारे frequencies को वो allow करते हैं, उसमें काफी low ripple है, और stop band में जो भी उनका ripple है, stop band में ज़्यादा है, बाकी अलग-अलग there are other types that I can get into details with, like Chebyshev type 1 or type 2, which have a lot of ripple in the pass band as well. They are used in some applications in audio as well, but again, that's we're not covering. We're just trying to be as basic as possible here. So the first thing that we are going to do is the Bessel. Now, as you can see, the attenuation that's written is it, jo unka crossover frequency pe jo hum log cutoff frequency pe jo cut kar rahe usko, wo change hote jata hai filter ke saath. Jo bhi hum log filter use kar rahe hai, the attenuation keeps increasing. It's not jo if you are saying we are going to cut it at minus, at maybe 100 hertz, is not going to be fixed at 6 dB down or 12 dB down or anything or something like that. As the order keeps increasing, जैसे ही उसका slope बढ़ते जाता है, the attenuation keeps increasing. So उसकी वजह से जो minus 6 dB point है, if it's a fixed attenuation, that frequency will keep changing. And again, because this उसका as we learned, you know, when you have two signals, if they are 6 dB down, 6 dB or 6 dB down, and if you add them and if they are in phase, you again get plus 6 dB, which will be zero if you're adding two signals which are minus 6 dB. With the exception of first order, you won't get flat summation, because the attenuation will be different for different slopes. And again, odd filters, you're going to be wasting a lot of energy due to the phase difference, but I can get into that later. They're also foolproof, because aap koi bhi apne, you know, engineer ya technician ko ye crossover use करने को बोल सकते हैं. As we've seen that the 90 degrees, when there's a phase difference of 90 degrees between two signals, you're still getting, instead of 6 dB, you're getting 3 dB. तो आपका 90 degree होने की वजह से या तो plus 90 degree होएगा या minus 90 degree होगा, कभी भी आपका इतना full cancellation या कुछ होगा नहीं, क्योंकि one way or the other, you're always either plus 90 or minus 90. So you're always going to be, adding to almost 3 dB. So that's why you call it foolproof. Not foolproof, but it's foolproof. And uska jo phase slope hai, bahut easy hai. We'll demonstrate it right now. I'm going to try and show my windows. So Nitesh, is windows visible now?
Yes, it's in
there. Okay, sorry.
Yes.
So those of you who've installed, this is the icon. You just double click it and it's going to open up this thing. And I'm just going to make sure my USB is connected to my Windows. And yes, it is. So I'm going to connect it. It is essentially a serial to COM port. So I'm going to check which COM port is connected on. It says COM3. My processor is on and I say, okay. It says it's online. Let it just load. This is a basic control window of my processor. Like you can see, it is yahan sab niche alag alag windows hai. So there's gains. I can also use my internal noise generator. So I can use pink noise from my processor. Like bahut logon ne pucha, can I use an external source? Yes, it has an analog noise generator. You can use white noise or pink noise and give one set to your sound card or dusra set to your system and then just measure it. This is your basic layout. You can change the routing the way you want it. You can mute your inputs. Right now my left and right is linked on top. Jaise ki aap dekh sakte hai, toh anything I do on channel 1 automatically affects channel 2. It has a noise gate. Jaise ki maine aapko samjhaya, noise gate mein you can set a parameter saying that below a certain level, no signal should be allowed to pass through. So if, let's say I'm getting a slight amount of hum or buzz or something, and then probably it gets masked in the noise floor when the show is on, or if a show mute pay, I can probably try and, if it's coming from an XLR input cable, I can set a noise gate and try and avoid it, saying that very low signal should not be allowed to pass through. So agar mera koi main mix ya high level signal ja raha nahi hai system mein, it pretty much gates everything out. It has my input gain. I have parametric EQs, a delay. You can invert the phase however you want. You can add compressors and limiters. Or for input, say I can go to my 6 individual channels. Like we said, we have used channel 1 for the sub. I've just connected channel 1 to the subwoofer, channel 3 to my mid-high. And I'm going to be using channel 5 to show you different processors. I'm going to also open Smart. Nitesh, is Smart visible?
Yes.
Okay. So ye jo hai, mera default hai. Like you can see in my data or your control center, I have nothing. So I'm going to quickly show you my input-output configuration. I'm using my PreSonus box. It's got input 1, input 2. I'm just going to quickly go ahead, not waste too much time. Isme I can set up a new transfer function. I can say webinar main 9 and measure channel is channel input 1, jahan main apna mic dene wala hu, and reference channel is channel input 2, where I have looped back my signal from the output to channel number 2. Jaise ki aapne wiring mein dekha. And I will use the signal generator from my from Smart itself, and it's using my PreSonus. So I'm just going to quickly switch it on, and I'm going to play my transfer function. And aap dekh sakte hai ki my measured signal is showing some value. So let me just check what is it on my okay. Let me just turn up the levels here, but one sec. It's still using my mic, so just hold on. So in my input, I'm just going to switch it from my processor. So just let me just give me a minute. I'm just going to change my input to my processor. And going back to my processor, I'm going to unmute it. Can you hear me?
Yeah,
sorry. So I'm just going to raise the level, and you can see the levels, or probably in from my noise generator, I'm going to probably make it minus 20. एंड एज यू कैन सी, जहां आप देख सकते हैं कि यहाँ एक देयर अ लो पास फिल्टर सेटअप. सो लेट्स क्विकली गो बैक एंड सी माय आउटपुट चैनल 5, एंड यू कैन सी दैट आई वाज जस्ट एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग. सो देयर वाज you know, a low, there's a high, no cutoff out here, but on the low pass section, there's a 48 dB and octave Linkwitz Riley crossover setup. So I'm just going to quickly change it to no cutoff so you can see what it is like. And I go back to smart and you can see the magnitude response is zero. Of course, I have to reduce my measure channel. As you can see, it's not exactly zero because my measured input is after removing the low pass filter, the measured channel is much more, and if I kind of match the levels, it comes and restores back to normal. Just to give you an idea, I've used an averaging of 1 second. 1 second mein jitne jitne samples aa gaye, main usko ye kar raha hun. Phase smoothing is 1/6 an octave. I'm comfortable 1/6. You can use 1/12 as well. It's usually what is what makes sense, readable to me. And you can see there's a phase वेरिएशन आउट हियर वेर इट्स शोइंग. नाउ यू कैन सी द स्लोप जो है, जैसे राजेश ने बताया आपको, दिस स्लोप इज लैगिंग एंड दैट इज बिकॉज माई साउंड कार्ड हैज सम फाइनाइट डिले. एंड इफ आई लुक इन टू द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ प्री सोनिस, इट सेज इट्स गोना हैव अ लेटेंसी ऑफ अबाउट 0.7 मिली सेकेंड. सो आई एम गोना क्विकली फाइंड दैट इट्स गोना बी शोइंग अबाउट 0.73. सो आई एम गोना इंसर्ट दैट लेटेंसी एंड इट्स गोना शो वॉट इज हैपनिंग. जस्ट टू again touch on what Rajesh had done, if I just show you what is happening out here, do hamare signal hai, ek jo hai generator aur dusra hai measure. The generator jo hai, it's traveling by electric cables, and of course we all know electric signals pass very fast. The electromagnetic signals, they almost pass at the speed of light, so it's almost 2 × 10⁸ meters per second. The speed of light is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. सो ये कछुए और खरगोश की कहानी है. जो खरगोश है हमारे वायर में एकदम फिनिश लाइन पे आ गया है, और कछुआ जो है हमारे स्पीकर से या कहाँ से वो अभी भी रुक रुक के आ रहा है, रुक रुक के आ रहा है. और हम लोग इसको खरगोश को बोले, नहीं आप हमारे साउंड कार्ड में मत आइए, हमको कछुए के लिए रुकना है. तो वी आर जस्ट गोना मार्क हिज पोजिशन एंड कैलकुलेट वॉट टाइम वुड इट टेक फॉर the tortoise to reach the signal and saying, okay, please wait, this is the propagation delay for its flight to travel from your speaker to your microphone, or from my DSP to my sound card, or and you know everything. So you're going to kind of wait for that and then add a delay. So if I go back, I've added a delay of 0.73 milliseconds, and now you see a pretty flat phase response and a magnitude response. There's a slight increase in level because the levels of my measured signal and reference signals are slightly different. That will of course vary with time to time. And I could kind of increase my reference signal a little and get it back to zero. So now you can see it's almost on zero. And going back to my processor, let's start. I mean, I'm just going to use a low pass filter, or let's start with a high pass filter, for example. Is using my input A, and let's start with maybe let's just do Linkwitz Riley because it's like we say, it's just got even orders because it's essentially two Butterworths in series. So we're going to 12 dB an octave, and like you can see my slope is changed. And let's go back to smart, and I'm going to leave the delay finder on so that any changes in delay, jo yellow button jo Rajesh ne dikhaya, is going to continuously look it on, and then I'm going to capture these traces and say LR high pass filter 12 dB an octave. Okay, so I'm capturing this, and I can go back and probably say 24 dB an octave of Linkwitz Riley, and you can see now the slope jo hai, jo hamara green trace hai, green is a live measurement trace, the pink is what I had saved, it's become a lot steeper. So I'll capture this and say Linkwitz Riley high pass filter, this is 24 dB an octave. And as you can see, jo dono traces ka jo intersection hai is, if you see on top of my smart screen, this is showing 100 hertz. So it's showing basically the same cutoff or rather corner frequency that you can say. Now, many people get confused by saying that if the roll-off is 24 dB an octave, so basically it means that 100 hertz, if my level is minus 6 dB, at 50 hertz, it should probably minus 6 plus minus 24, which should be minus 30. But it's actually from the pass band and not from the corner frequency. So if you see the level at, say, if I go down to 50 hertz, it's showing minus 24. And it's showing minus 24 because my pass band here is at 0 dB. So always remember the slope is going to be maintaining. So it's going to be maintaining with respect to pass band. But again, as you go from 50 to 25, you will again see a minus 48. So aapko jyada confuse nahi karna hai, but basically just to get you know that the slope is getting steeper and steeper. And if I go back to my processor and change it to maybe 36 dB an octave, and out here I'm going to get an even more slope and say LR high pass filter 36. And I'm going to repeat this for a 48 dB an octave Linkwitz Riley. And as you see here, it's just going to get even more steep. So it's LR high pass filter 48 dB. Now, if I go and change this and I say I don't want this to be a high pass filter and I want this to be a low pass filter, and let's just say it's Linkwitz Riley again. So it's 12 dB an octave Linkwitz Riley. And I go back to smart, and now you're going to see hamara jo trace hai, it's again at 100 hertz, it's intersecting the same point, and it's showing a similar attenuation. So I'm just going to do maybe two or three, not all of them, just to give you an idea to show you that they all are functioning. So I'll capture this and say LR low pass filter 12 dB, and again go back and probably just do 24 dB. And you can see back in smart, it's become steeper. So it's capturing LR low pass filter 24 dB. Let's change the crossover type. And I'm just going to hide these so we don't see much. But I'll just show probably the 24 dB low pass filter and the 24 dB high pass filter. So agar hamari ye do signal hai, jaise ki Rajesh ne bataya, it's showing minus 6 dB for each out here, and both of them, they are pretty much going to be adding up. If in phase, if they both are in phase, they're going to add up and show, both are going to be showing you an addition. But out here, like we can see, there is a phase shift of 180 degrees. So it's probably going to show you cancellation right now. And that's because if you see my delay finder out here, jo pehle 0.73 tha on your low pass filter, is now changed to about 5 milliseconds. And many people said, there's a question somewhere, beech mein kisi ne pucha tha, can I find a delay finder for my subs with a delay finder? And the answer to that is because you'll get a very ambiguous answer, because a low frequency, because of the way it is, you're going to find a lot of the time smear in the impulse response will be quite wide, because it has very large time periods, and because of that you're going to get a very ambiguous reading sometimes, which may not be very accurate for you to find with a delay finder. The best way is to understand either with your, if you can read your impulse response correctly, agar aap impulse response theek se pad sakte is one way, or the easiest way that I use is to match the phase response. Bahut se log purane zamane mein kya karte the, apna subwoofer ka frequency response badhate the. And if you see what happens, if you increase the low pass filter, you're just going to change your delay time. So if I'm going to increase my low pass filter to say maybe 1 kilohertz, now you can see jo mera jo delay finder hai, it's about 1.2 milliseconds. And you can see my green trace is moved a lot further ahead, and the minus 6 dB point is moved to 1 kilohertz. But the minute, and many people use this to find the delay for the subwoofers, because that's, it's giving, if I open my impulse response, so why is my impulse response not showing. Rajesh, any idea why the impulse response not showing?
Yeah, this thing is off. The
sorry. Okay, so you can see the peak is coming at 1.21. And what happens is that the minute you change your low, you add a low pass filter, and you know, right now you're getting a well-defined impulse response. But the minute you go and, you know, add your low pass filter, you know, the phase shift added is a lot more. The time period changes drastically. So using this as a reference is not going to be correct, because in spite of adding higher frequencies to your subwoofer, you may get a more well-defined impulse response. But as soon as I go and change my frequency back using the same delay, the actual delay is no longer 1.21, but it's somewhere around 5 milliseconds. So your delay finder, you may just delay your subwoofer by 1.21 milliseconds. But at the minute you come, you bring your frequency, your low-pass filter back to about 100 hertz or 90 hertz, it's actually you need to add another 3 or 4. So it's the best way to is just to match your phase traces, and we'll see how we do that when we do the measurement. I'm just going to quickly go over these things so that you get an idea. And looking at just 1 second, let me just go through different filter types quickly. So if I'm going to be looking at Bessel, which we did in our presentation, so 12 dB and octave Bessel filter. I'm just going to hide my Linkwitz Riley. So this is my 12 dB and octave Bessel filter, and I'm going to capture it and say LPF Bessel 12 dB. And again, if I move back and change it to a higher slope, so I've got on a Bessel, I've got 24 dB and octave, and where you're seeing, which is actually 100 hertz, let's say 100 hertz, on both the curves, there is a slight difference, and I'll kind of show it a little better when I add one more. So, low pass filter, Bessel, 24 dB. And then again, it's 100 hertz, so I'm going to change it to maybe, I don't have more than 24 dB, but if I change my scale and add 100 hertz on smart, so if I go to options, config, transfer function, and just change my range to max is 15 and minimum is minus 15. So aap dekh sakte hai at 100 hertz, where is 100 hertz? It's somewhere here. Yeah. So this is 100 hertz. You can see there is a difference in the corner frequency or cutoff frequency in the level. The attenuation that you have at 100 hertz is different for 12 dB and octave and 24 dB and octave. So just going back to our presentation, we are seeing that the attenuation changes, the cutoff frequency attenuation changes with the filter order. As you go higher and higher, it keeps changing, and then leaving the first order, we don't have flat summation anywhere else. Now, we've done Linkwitz Riley. I will do Butterworth now, but Linkwitz Riley, just what we did right now, it has constant attenuation. So you can see the minus 6 dB point of all the filter orders was all at 100 hertz. And because of that, because it's minus 6 dB, you have flat summation. We don't have odd filters because a Linkwitz Riley is essentially a Butterworth, two Butterworths in series. And the phase slope is the change in phase is a lot more gradual. I'll just quickly show you all Butterworth right now. So moving back to smart, I'm going to hide my Bessel. And just to quickly show you all my Linkwitz Riley filter, you can see all of them are kind of coinciding at 100 hertz. So basically Linkwitz Riley, all crossover frequency is aimed at 100 hertz. So I'm going to start showing you a Butterworth filter, what it is and where do we use it.
Karan, a bit more in Hindi, I think few people are asking.
जैसे कि आपने देखा कि Linkwitz Riley का फिल्टर का जो क्रॉसओवर फ्रीक्वेंसी सॉरी बिकॉज देयर वाज शॉर्टेज ऑन टाइम आई वाज जस्ट ट्राइंग टू
या नो प्रॉब्लम
या जैसे कि आपने देखा Linkwitz Riley के जो कॉर्नर फ्रीक्वेंसीज है वो हमेशा का उसका फ्रीक्वेंसी फिक्स्ड है और वो उसका हमेशा जो फ्लैट बैंड है 0 dB से वो -6 dB नीचे होगा और इसका जैसे ही हम ऑर्डर बढ़ाते जाएंगे आप देखेंगे कि इसका स्लोप बढ़ते जाते हैं। अगर मैं सिर्फ अगर हाई पास फिल्टर करूं तो जो हमारे पहले था ये 12 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव था उसको, एंड यू कैन सी उसका अगर आप साथ में फेस ट्रेस भी देखेंगे तो काफ़ी डिसेंटली स्मूथ फेस ट्रेस है। उसका ये मैं 24 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव करूं तो आप देखेंगे उसका फेस जो स्लोप है काफ़ी थोड़ा स्टीप हो गया है। कॉर्नर फ्रीक्वेंसी जो 100 हर्ट्ज़ पे -6 डीबी पॉइंट है वो सेम रहता है, बट फेज जो है और बदल रहा है। आप देख सकते हैं पहले ये -80 से, सो बेसिकली दिस इज अ सर्कुलर स्केल बट जस्ट टू गिव एन आइडिया, ये -180 से लेके 0 तक आ रहा है, और ये जो आप देख रहे हैं ये 0 से लेके -180 और वही कंटिन्यू होके ऊपर से वापस चेंज होके 0 तक आ रहा है। तो यू आर सीइंग ऑलमोस्ट अक्रॉस अ फुल दिस थिंग, यू आर सीइंग ऑलमोस्ट 24 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव। रिमेंबर द चार्ट दैट वी शोड, एवरी जो हर एक फिल्टर का ऑर्डर है उसमें 90 डिग्रीज का फेस शिफ्ट आने वाला है। तो ये 24 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव है, तो ये फोर्थ ऑर्डर है। फोर्थ ऑर्डर मतलब 4 × 90, 360 डिग्री का फेस शिफ्ट आपने अपने फेज ग्राफ में आप हमेशा एक्सपेक्ट करेंगे इसको। और जैसे कि जो सेकेंड ऑर्डर था 12 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव, उसमें आप 180 डिग्रीज का फेस शिफ्ट आप एक्सपीरियंस करेंगे। वील गेट टू नो अबाउट वॉट इज इन फेज वेन यू डूइंग द मेजरमेंट राइट नाउ। एंड लास्टली लास्ट में हम बटरवर्थ फिल्टर अगर देखेंगे तो इफ आई एम लुकिंग एट प्रॉबेबली 6 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव ऑफ बटरवर्थ, एंड वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू लुक एट द लो पास फिल्टर सेक्शन नाउ अगेन। सो वी आर गोइंग टू गो बैक टू स्मार्ट एंड मेजर इट। सो हम ये हम सेव करेंगे, ये 6 डीबी एन ऑक्टेव बटरवर्थ है, लो पास फिल्टर 6 डीबी बटरवर्थ, और इस पे जो हमने 100 हर्ट्ज पे हमने क्रॉस किया है, अगर 100 हर्ट्ज हम यहाँ देखेंगे इसका जो पॉइंट है वो अराउंड 3 डीबी नीचे है। तो आप सोच सकते हैं अगर हमने बटरवर्थ का फिल्टर यूज किया जो 3 डीबी और 3 डीबी का जो ये है दो सिग्नल, हमने अगर उसको बटरवर्थ फिल्टर दिए वो हमें फ्लैट नहीं मिलेगा 0 डीबी पे, पर उसका एक 3 डीबी -3 डीबी प्लस -3 डीबी का कम होने की वजह से आपको एक +3 डीबी का एक बम्प दिखेगा। सो दैट्स व्हाई यू गेट अ बम्प व्हेन यू आर एडिंग टू बटरवर्थ फिल्टर्स। आई डोंट हैव द ऑप्शन हियर टू ऐड टू सिग्नल्स हियर लाइक, बट इफ यू गाइस वांट टू सी हाउ बटरवर्थ फिल्टर्स वर्क, राजेश आपको दिखा सकते हैं अपने स्मार्ट पे दो बटरवर्थ फिल्टर्स लगा के, और आप देख सकते हैं कि वो +3 डीबी पे दिखेगा। और वैसे ही मैं अगर सेम उसका फिल्टर ऑर्डर बढ़ाते जाऊं, -6 डीबी पे किया और उसको मैंने वापस -12 डीबी पे वापस रिपीट किया, आई कैप्चर दिस अगेन और यू कैन सी अस लो पास फिल्टर ऑफ 12 डीबी ऑफ बटरवर्थ। जो आप देख रहे हैं इसका जो कॉर्नर फ्रीक्वेंसी है जो 100 हर्ट्ज, इट्स स्टेइंग कॉन्स्टेंट। जो स्लोप है थोड़ा और स्टीप हो गया, बट ये हमेशा ये जो ये है 100 हर्ट्ज पे ही रहेगा। और तो ये इसका आप देखेंगे कि ये अभी भी -3 डीबी पे ही है। सो यू आर गोना गेट अ बम्प, दैट्स व्हाई बटरवर्थ इज ऑलवेज कॉल्ड अ बम्प फिल्टर, बिकॉज इट गिव्स यू अ काइंड ऑफ अ नाइस बम्प। आई एम नॉट गोना गेट इनटू टू मच डिटेल फर्दर ऑन दिस काइंड ऑफ फिल्टर्स, बट आपको सब स्मार्ट अभी यूज करने लगभग बेसिक आ गया होगा, तो यू कैन जस्ट take the hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, it said it was unstable internet or something. So aap smart use karke hamesha aap dekh sakte hai ki aapka ek processor ka jo output hai, it's always good to measure. I'm not going to name the brand, but just to give you a basic insight, I had tried ek limiter function use karne ko and added some threshold, a very popular brand, one of, I think would be one of the best selling brands in today's market in India for a DSP, but usme limiter function, maybe they've corrected this fact before because I saw a lot of people even complaining about it online. Or you know, threshold, if you aap signal pass karte the jo threshold set karne ke bawajood wo threshold ke upar wo signal ko pass karne deta tha, and even something like a square wave would pass through very easily. So always check your processors. It's a good idea. Check your, that's what I said. Get familiar with your equipment, see what is happening, and just get an idea of what you're exactly doing. So I'm just going to quickly get into measurements right now. Let me see if I have just to cover some few things on the same before we actually get into measurements. We've covered crossovers and we also use parameters.